Welcome to
Cali.com.
Oh yeah. Show off. Too much booty in the camera, though.
That's just some behind the scenes juices for y'all. Anyway.
Alone.
AP! One in a billion and I'm back.
And it's your favorite diva, Dangerous Diva.
Oh, yeah.
And we're back with the AP and Diva Show.
AP and Diva Show, AP and Diva.
And we're back.
You know what I mean? Make sure you subscribe.
Yes, click the yellow button.
We don't have an AP and Diva Show channel yet. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Make sure you log on to welcometocali.com. Look for our new show, the AP and Diva Show.
It's hot.
Oh yeah.
We'll keep you entertained.
And we'll cut each other off when we're talking.
That's what husband and wives do.
Oh yeah.
We finish each other's sentences.
Oh. You were supposed to say yeah.
Yeah.
That's how we finished the sentences.
Gotta give it to you all. So first, fresh off the press, a lot of rumors speculating that will Beyonce and Kim Kardashian ever be friends?
Will they ever get along?
Will they ever? They come from different backgrounds, and is it gonna work? Rumors saying that Beyonce doesn't want her near her or Jay-Z. Gwyneth Paltrow saying that she doesn't even want to be seen in a photo with her.
Who in the world is Gwyneth Paltrow?
Yeah, well, anyway. Like her best friend. So, breaking news, they were seen tonight. They were spotted today at the concert, the Watch the Throne concert, cheering their men on. Yeah, seriously, it was so bad that people thought that the picture was Photoshopped. Like, they thought that people put Kim in the picture with Beyonce.
Yeah.
Like, this isn't true. Supposedly, a lot of Beyonce fans are upset.
But we got the video, so we know for a fact it is true.
Yeah, in England, it was the final concert of the Watch the Throne tour, which kind of makes me think that this whole Kim Kardashian feud with Beyonce was fake. Because now all of a sudden on the final tour date, the two are seen together.
Oh, so this is all part of a show like, dun, dun, dun. Yeah. Here they are, and now they've bonded.
At last, they're together. But it was kind of weird. Beyonce did kind of look like she was hiding.
Yeah, she was all hiding. She was like, she was hiding like that.
And then Kim was
like, oh, I'm posing. Oh, Beyonce, we're hiding? Okay,
you know,
let's hide
Kim
too.
Kim never hides for a photo. What has she ever hidden?
This was the photo. Was like,
she was like, oh, I gotta hide too. Like, come on.
Trying to be black.
Like, just be you.
This is what we do when we black, right? All right. If you want to do that, I'll do that.
Beyonce, yeah, she hides with a camera. She has a baby from the camera. But Kim hiding from a camera? Never seen that before.
You know.
But the whole thing was hilarious. All right. So.
Next. All right. Before we say that, just fans, what do you think of that? Do you approve of Beyonce and Kim Kardashian building a relationship? Leave your comments below. Let us know.
I think it's time for a birthday.
A birthday?
Yes. We got several watchers that have a birthday.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Shout out to all of our stans, our fans, all of our peoples. Happy birthday. It's your birthday. This song is for you.
Press Love and Hip Hop ATL. We told you that show was
wow.
That is crazy. Wild Wild West.
Wild Wild West.
But if they're not out here in Cali, they are out.
Wild Wild South.
Getting it in.
The Wild Wild South. So what happened?
So we kind of told you about the K. Michelle story. K. Michelle said her former ex-boyfriend, who was a VP at Jive Records, got her a $2 million record deal. Supposedly, he spent all her money and beat her down. Beat her.
What he spent her money on?
Well, according to his statement, let me read this to you. Memphis is his name. He finally responded back to her allegations of him beating her and taking her money. He posted a photo of Pinocchio with the caption, "As I was installing the teeth, the titties, and the buttocks, I'll just say, you're flaunting right now. I forgot to tell you about the growing nose I threw in also, Pinocchio."
Wow.
"Laughing out loud, I made you."
Wow.
Woo! I'm sorry, but whoa.
So
what a comeback.
So you mean to tell me that all of that is fake? You know what I mean?
That's sad. Honestly, I think some of the stories are orchestrated on the show, like the whole tranny looking dude, Jocelyn Joe, or whatever her name is.
I'm talking about Stevie the booty. J. The booty is fake?
That's what he's saying. Her booty's fake, her titties are fake, and even her teeth are fake.
Teeth fake?
He bought those too.
Wow.
So she can't really complain too much because we know where some of that $2 million went.
Yeah, and to build it up her image.
Upgrading her image.
A la Nicki Minaj.
It's sickening, honestly, to me. Being a curvy girl, naturally curvy girl, it's just so bizarre to me that everyone wants to be curvy.
Listen, this is real over here. This is real. You know what I'm saying?
No injections.
You know what I'm saying?
Silly.
This dangerous demon.
No. What? Wait.
Hey, I can't keep my hands off. You know what I mean?
I'm just saying.
But it's real though. It's real in the film.
No injections. I mean, now it's like people are obsessed with the whole media, like portraying big booties. Now that everybody can get a big booty, because you know sister's been having booty, but now it's like booty for all.
Listen.
Booty for all. It's so weird.
So listen, dudes. Us dudes, like me, the dudes that, you know, if you have been with a lot of chicks with a lot of, you done seen a lot of big booties, you know when one is real or one is fake. If it's all curved and it's square like clank, clank, if it's going like that, it's not real, all right?
Trust me, I know. It's not real.
I'm a pro. I know, and look at my baby. But anyway,
back to that statement. It's honestly with the story, you kind of think, is she doing this for fame? She didn't pop with the $2 million contract. She didn't pop.
Of course, she's doing the show.
Where?
For fame.
No. I'm saying the allegations. Where's the police reports? Did you at least file a police report? Like you're saying that like nothing. Did you do anything? There is no proof on the table. He's calling her Pinocchio and stating the facts that he upgraded her body.
Well, he ain't never denied. He didn't say nothing about her getting beat. So
nope.
He ain't not denying that.
He didn't own up to it.
And he's not denying it.
No.
So he just changed the subject.
He did.
So he did a good job of changing the subject, but he ain't denying it.
Is that a sign of an abuser? Him not owning up to it or denying it? Because he dissed her. He clowned her.
Listen, leave y'all comments below. Tell us what y'all think. Is K. Michelle's story true? And what do you think about her body? Is her body real or is it fake? Like, what is going on?
And let me give you her response. She responded by saying, "A person's true colors will always show. Never fight a battle God already won for you." Good response.
Good response.
Tasteful.
All right.
So I guess she's saying, Toya, prepare to get your butt beat. I'm just saying.
And what if that really happens? What Lil Wayne gonna do about that?
Uh-oh.
Does he still care for her? I never watched
the
show.
Well, she is the mother of his child.
I don't know.
Of his children.
Whoa.
She is a baby mom. She wasn't just like an ex. So
you know.
Who knows what could pop off. Stay tuned.
Next topic.
BET Awards 2012 is here, baby. Coming up July 1st.
Yeah.
Superhost Samuel L. Jackson. That's my dude. He's so good. It's gonna be entertaining. I already know. He started off with a trailer for the show, doing a rendition of Nicki Minaj, Bees in the Trap.
And he had on a pink wig.
Lace front. Oh. It almost looked better than hers. I'm just saying.
He had on the pink joint and all that. I mean, it was hilarious. Tell me what you thought of it, and what do you think? Is Nicki Minaj going to take this personal? Because she takes a lot of things personal.
You know, she's super sensitive.
Is she going to find this entertaining? Because, you know, some things are funny. You know, and that was pretty funny.
It was funny.
But
it was
hilarious. And what are you expecting for the performances? She's performing. Chris Brown's performing.
I hear Sissy Houston's performing the Whitney Houston tribute. He said they locked everybody in that they wanted. And it's going to be the best Whitney Houston tribute. I guess so. They got her mom. Wow. And I don't know who else they got. But
exactly. That's crazy.
Kanye, Minaj, Rick Ross, Meek Mill, Usher, Chris Brown, Wale, 2 Chainz. Is something going to pop off?
Uh-oh.
Is the whole Meek Mill, Chris Brown, Drake thing squashed? Or is something going to pop off?
You know? I want to.
Who knows?
Wonder Tony Parker going to be there for that too.
Yeah, because I heard he's suing.
He's
like
what,
the first
million?
Lawsuit. 20.
20 million?
20 million.
All the money this dude get?
Baby, 20
that's,
million.
That's his moneymaker right there.
Oh,
that's his moneymaker.
Trying to party with the youngins.
You know?
See what it got you. Also, believe it or not, D'Angelo is hitting the stage. It's been 12 years since he's been on the stage.
Oh my God.
He's
D'Angelo
back.
Is back?
Back.
Wow.
Bringing it. Uh-oh. So, hopefully we got a good show lined up for us.
Hey,
I'm excited.
That's what's up.
The last story of the night. Believe it or not, a single mom in Texas received a $1.3 million electric bill. Can you believe that? Seriously.
How is that even possible?
Potentia Energy, not SCE, thank God, charged her $1,000 per kilowatt instead of 9 cents per kilowatt.
What?
Yeah. I wonder if she could sue.
You know what I'm saying?
Seriously.
Because I know her lights is off right now.
Imagine if she was on auto payment. Seriously.
Sheesh.
If she were to pay her late charges would be $66,000.
Wow. Are you serious?
Yes.
If she was on auto payment, all her accounts is going to be just dumb.
Right?
It's going to look negative. One, I don't even think it's going to clear anyway.
It's awful. Could you imagine getting over a million dollar electric bill
for the month? That is crazy.
But she has an autistic child, so hopefully they kept her lights on.
They better have kept them lights on.
Or that's a lawsuit.
What is going on?
What is going on in the world?
You know what I mean?
Cheating people, she's trying to take advantage of people. And this is a single mom, not like she was capable.
That's crazy.
So, that's all, folks.
Oh, yeah. One in a billion.
And your favorite diva, Dangerous Diva.
She obviously was trying to tell me something that I was supposed to say first. We'll say that afterwards.
Right, so but we're signing out.
We gotta get up out of here. My wife look good.
Oh.
What time is it?
I think it's time for some music.
Oh. Yeah.
Some hot music.
Check out this video right here. Tell me what you think of that. New song out, Hype With It, Light With It, aka All Night With It, and the video is coming soon. I know so many people have been asking for the video. I know y'all been waiting on me, but you know I had to make sure we just got it right. We got the song professionally mixed and mastered now, so I mean it sounded on a whole nother level, and I hope y'all really like this song. This song right here is it's important to me. When I had the inspiration behind making the track for All Night, I started coming in contact with a lot of dancers. You got all these different movements. You got the jerk movement. You got the kids that get light. You got kids that crump. You got all these different type of movements. I'm like, man, I need to make a track that I can attract all of these type of kids to this song. Like this is like kind of like a shout out to all my peoples that do that. So I mean, it's one of the top dance anthems out there. Make sure you click that like button. Make sure you subscribe. And make sure that you download AP One in a Billion All Night on iTunes. Hot song. You'll love it. Your kids will love it. Just nice, feel-good, clean music. Download the song now and spread it to all your peoples. Make sure you do that.
Yo, big shout out to AP.
You already know. AP came all the way out
from Cali.
We came AP, all the way to, from Newark, New Jersey. Because that's how much love we got for him.
That's how much love
he got on the East Coast. He can do that. He can call people up like, yo, come dance. All right, we got you. Say no more. We out here.
We out here. Big shout out to Cali. You already know.
Shout out. What's up? Mr. Ray.
Shout out to AP.
Message music, you already know my name.
Nigga Night. Ah! Oh my god, oh my god, god damn, oh my god, oh my god, god damn,
AP.
Oh my god,
message music,
oh my god, oh my god,
okay,
my god, oh my god, my god, oh my god.
That beat is sick.
Good looking. It's telling you this song gonna pop, dude.
Hype with it, light with it, we gonna get nice with it. We can do it all night with it, hype with it, light with it, we gon' get nice with it. We can do it all night with it, hype with it, light with it, we gon' get nice with it. We can do it all night with it, hype with it, light with it, we gon' get nice with it. We can do it all night with it.
Minute, miss me, throw me in the ward, my flow is sick, please. Consider the pros and cons before quickie, on the summit from the king, ever sent me.
We can do it all night with it, hype with it, light with it, we gon' get nice.